Hi, I'm David Molina, and I'm the co-owner and head coach of Next Level Fitness La Quinta. And I wanted to make this video to go over my top 5 tips to having a successful year in fitness this 2020. So step one would be write down your goals. Finalize what your goals are for this year or what the short-term goals are. And use the SMART method. Make sure you're being as specific as you possibly can and make sure that you know exactly what you want to do. Don't just say lose weight, say how much weight, how much fat, what you want to do with that, or whatever the goal may be specific with the goal, make sure you can measure it, make sure it's attainable, make sure it's something that you can realistically do. And what you always want to do is make sure that it's time sensitive. Put an end date, because if you don't put an end date on something, the end never comes. And that means when it comes to a goal, the accomplishment never comes. Step 2, eliminate the room for error. How do you do this? Figure out all the A's, B's, and C's. Figure out everything that you need to figure out about your goal, meaning how much you weigh, how much body fat percentage you might have, and you know what your BMR may be, so you can figure out how many calories you need to have every single day, and then that way you can get the exact macros that you need. Because if you have everything done down to the last calorie, how can you fail? There is no room for you to fail, because everything you're doing is gonna help you take a step forward. So study and research exactly what you need to be doing, or come to your coach and ask your coach for help. That way you can eliminate the room for error. Step 3, go the extra mile. Do not cut corners. Because when it comes to your goal, at first you're gonna have all the motivation in the world. You're gonna wanna reach out. You're gonna wanna lose 20 pounds, whatever it may be, right? But once you start really going, of course it's difficult to do what you want to do. If it wasn't difficult, you would have done it already, right? So when it starts to get difficult, instead of taking the easy way out, you know, playing the guessing game, maybe having the slice of cake here and there, and doing the little cheats and the little cutting the corners, you're not doing all the reps you need to be doing, all of that, right? When you do that, it's only going to hinder you. So make sure, even when you start to get tired, even when you start to get close to the goal, which ends up being the hardest part, once you're weeks away and days away from the goal and you're almost there, that seems to be the last little stretch, seems to be the hardest, because you've been doing it for so long. Don't lose the motivation, don't cut the corners, because at the end of the day, those little corners and those little extra reps are gonna help you in the end, and they're actually gonna make it a lot easier for you to accomplish your goal. Step 4, have accountability, have a coach. Let people that are close to you, that have your best interests at heart, like your Fit in 42 coach, to let them know what you're doing with your goals. Let them know exactly what the goal is. If it is for the weight loss or whatever it may be, so then they can check up on you and they can hold you accountable and, you know, see where you're at with your goal. Maybe you're not moving forward and maybe you need that little kick in the butt, and they're gonna give it to you. So always have someone to hold you accountable. Have your Fit in 42 coach. We'll always be here for you. And the final step, step 5, stick to the plan. Always stick to the plan. Again, this almost goes into step 3 with cutting the corners, but stick to the plan at the end of the day, even when the plan gets hard. Even when you don't feel the plan is working, stick to the plan. If you eliminate all the room for error, you'll know that the plan is gonna work at the end of the day. What ends up happening a lot of the time is somebody will try to lose weight, or they'll try to gain muscle, or they try to gain endurance, and whatever it may be, and they start a program, but they don't see it all the way through. And you'll never find out if it's gonna work if you don't see it all the way through. A lot of people will end up trying to quit halfway through or right off the bat because they're not seeing results immediately. They're not losing pounds immediately. But if they just went that extra little mile, they will start to see the results. So you have to see it all the way through to find out if it's gonna work or not. Do not quit early. Stick to your plan. Create the plan, follow the plan, and then stick to the plan, and you will succeed. I hope these tips help, and I hope you have a plan for this new upcoming year when it comes to your health and your fitness, and that way you can move forward in a more healthier lifestyle. If you would like to, follow us at our Instagram, Fit42 Coachella Valley, and leave us a like on our videos so that more people can see our videos, and that way we can help as many people as possible this new 2020.